Wow, my heart was touched the other day when my husband showed me a film clip from a famous story. It was about a 9-year-old, very poor boy who was often desperately hungry. He lived in a Victorian workhouse and nervously went to ask the cruel overseer for more food. His name was Oliver Twist. But please, let's look at this clip to see what happened. All over the world, people are hungry for more food, for more love, for more joy, more peace, for more meaning, and so often they are left empty. The Bible tells us that God wants the hungry to be fed, both physically and spiritually. He doesn't ever want to turn us away or treat us harshly, like Oliver Twist. He experienced really a difficult situation. Instead, as the hymn "Bread of Heaven" says, he wants to feed us now and evermore. I love that hymn. As Christians, we should always confidently come to Jesus, who he fed the multitudes and told us to pray for daily bread. Always we should ask for more, more love, more resources, more fruitfulness, and more of the power of the Holy Spirit. The increasing ministry of the Holy Spirit was one of the biggest reasons that the church in the first century grew so rapidly and brought great, great positive change to individuals and even whole cities. Ephesus, as we have heard, was one of the great cities of the ancient world. For the gospel to have any impact, the Apostle Paul knew that he needed more of the Holy Spirit to work in him and through him. And the people of Ephesus, including the believers, they needed to experience much more of the Holy Spirit. Well, the Holy Spirit did come in great power. We read about in Acts 19. This resulted in the whole city being shaken, which we will hear more about next week. But today, I want to focus this week on some important areas where the believers discovered that God had a lot more for them and their community than they had previously imagined. Always, God has more. God also wants to give us as individuals and as church much more than we had ever known before. And so, he wants us to ask for more and expect more. First of all, we can know more of the power of the Holy Spirit, and this is my focus today. This chapter starts with the powerful teaching from Apostle Paul that We need the baptism of the Holy Spirit. In Acts 19:1-7, there were about 12 disciples who understood the importance of repentance and believing in Jesus, but who needed to be filled with the Holy Spirit. Let's read this passage in Acts 19. While Apollos was at Corinth, Paul took the road through the interior and arrived at Ephesus. There he found some disciples and asked them, "Did you receive the Holy Spirit when you believed?" They answered, "No, we have not even heard that there is a Holy Spirit." So Paul asked, "Then what baptism did you receive?" "John's baptism," they replied. Paul says, "John's baptism was a baptism of repentance. He told the people to believe in the one coming after him, that is, in Jesus. On hearing this, they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. When Paul placed his hand on them, the Holy Spirit came on them, and they spoke in tongues and prophesied." There were about 12 men in all. The Christians in Ephesus had received the gospel and they believed in Jesus Christ. They had even repented of their sins when they believed, and they were baptized in water, as is often the case with many, many Christians today. But they didn't experience the Holy Spirit that Jesus promised to us before he went to heaven. That is also the case with many Christians today. But we should remember that we need the Holy Spirit just as the early Christians did. Jesus says to his disciples in Acts 1:8, "Remember, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you." Jesus knew that we would need the Holy Spirit to spread the gospel in all the world. It's necessary to have that supernatural power. We need the supernatural power of the baptism of the Holy Spirit to be the best witnesses and disciples of Jesus. Maybe today you don't know much about the Holy Spirit, but you need to. When you experience the Holy Spirit, he reveals Jesus to you and puts a burning love in your heart for others. That is only the Holy Spirit can do that. Or maybe you do know about the Holy Spirit, some things. You hear maybe about the Holy Spirit, but you need to be filled with more of the Holy Spirit than you have ever known before. And today is your day. Thank God you are a good and faithful Christian, but are you maybe a disciple who seeks to be daily filled with the Holy Spirit? And I am asking daily, because the Holy Spirit will help us every day, in everything, in all. We need to be like the 12 disciples in Ephesus, who were highly responsive to receive more of the Holy Spirit. When they discovered that there was so much more of on offer than they had previous experience, all movements of renewal, revival, and reformation begin like this, with individuals and a small group of people who become dissatisfied with their spirit state and the state of the world around them. And then they begin to pray and hunger for more of God, more of God. Billy Graham was in his mid-30s. He told a British friend, Stephen Otford, that he knew he lacked spiritual power. He said, "I must have more of the Holy Spirit," he said. After praying together for more and for some hours, Billy Graham said he knew he had received more of the Holy Spirit. From that time, his whole ministry changed and went to another level of international impact. because the Holy Spirit made the difference in us. Dr. Martin Lloyd-Jones, in his book Revival, says of our need of the Holy Spirit, we must ask ourselves how we can succeed if we do not have this strength and power. We must become utterly and absolutely convinced of our need. We have got to realize that we must be filled with God's Spirit. And he asked about the present state of the church and the world. Do you ever pray for the power of God in the church today? Surely, no one should need to be convinced today that nothing short of a mighty revival of the Holy Spirit is adequate to deal with our situation. Let me ask, how aware are you of your need of more of the Holy Spirit? How hungry are we as a church for the power and for the presence of God? Well, we need to be. For this is the time to keep praying for more of the Holy Spirit. Amen? Next, we can know more of the gifts of the Holy Spirit. In Acts 19:6 says, when Paul placed his hands on them, the Holy Spirit came on them and they spoke in tongues and prophesied. Speaking in tongues is what happened when the Holy Spirit came in power. That told in the day of the Pentecost, when the Jews from every nation heard the disciples declaring the wonders of God in their own languages. Speaking in tongues was also evident when the Holy Spirit came upon the non-Jewish believers in the home of Cornelius, when was basically the first cell group. Speaking in tongues was part, basically, of a normal New Testament Christian experience. The Apostle Paul frequently spoke in tongues. This gift of God brings a supernatural freedom to speak to God in prayers and worship, and also to declare the word of God. Sometimes to speak to people in their own languages, as has happened in different documented cases. Also, prophecy. Prophecy is a liberation by the Holy Spirit to speak words in your own language, that these words strengthen and direct the church. Prophecy clearly declares God's word and purpose. In 1 Corinthians chapter 12 and chapter 14 shows that speaking in tongues and prophecy are just two of a number of spiritual gifts that we can receive. These charters also give clear guidance of how and when to use this gift. I recommended you to read these two charters. The Apostle Paul says in 1 Corinthians 14 that we should follow the way of love and eagerly desire spiritual gifts, especially the gift of prophecy. And also in 1 Corinthians, in the same chapter, verse 39 says, be eager to prophesy and do not forbid speaking in tongues, but everything should be done in a fitting and orderly way. As Christians, then we should develop all the gifts and talents God has given us, but also seek after those gifts that the Holy Spirit will give us if we ask for more. And finally, if we ask for more, we can know more of the miraculous works of the Holy Spirit. Like healing of the sick. Healing of the sick people were a key part of the ministry of Jesus and a constant feature of the early church. Many healings are recorded in the book of Acts. But in Ephesus, things obviously move to another level. For Luke records in verse 11 and 12, God did extraordinary miracles through Paul, so that even handkerchiefs and aprons that had touched him were taken to the sick, and their illnesses were cured, and the evil spirit left them. In other words, the ministry of divine healing is part of ordinary of normal Christianity. But what went on in Ephesus was extraordinary. There was a very, very special time of healing when the anointing of God on Paul was so strong that anything that touched him and was taken to the sick, like handkerchief and aprons, resulted in healing. That was an amazing power. That is why we need to ask for more and more. We too should pray always and believe to see miracles becoming a much more normal part of church, of our church life, and that we should always recognize that God can keep increasing the level of anointing. Anointing for healing not only is a great blessing to the sick, it is also a sign of God's kingdom authority at work in the world, and this power makes people take notice. Another would be deliverance from evil spirit. Healing is also associated with expelling evil spirit from people. This is what happened here, as it did in the ministry of Jesus. But there is also a warning to be sure that you have the anointing and authority of the Holy Spirit when bringing deliverance, because in verses 13 and 16 reveal that those who tried this as a religion formula were themselves beaten up by the evil spirit. Be careful. First, have more of the Holy Spirit, so you cannot play about with the power of God. Always we should see our great need of God, and always we should be confident that we can receive His power when we pray, "More Lord, more Lord." That need to be our prayer today. Let's pray where you are, in your home, but especially if you are first time watching or this program or listen the word of God, please bow your heads. I would like to pray with you. I want to pray for those who want to be forgiven of their sins and come close to God. If you do, please pray with me. Heavenly Father, thank you for your great love. Thank you, Lord, because you sent your only Son, Jesus Christ, to die for us at the cross. Thank you, Lord, because you forgive our sins and you give us a new life. But also, Lord, thank you because you sent to us your Holy Spirit that we need more and more. We receive you, Lord, today. Please save me, Lord. Save me and forgive all my sins. Give me a new life. I pray today with all my heart in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Now, if you pray this from your heart, to be sure that God hears you and welcomes you into His family, we also welcome you and we want to help you to grow as a Christian. So please contact us or write to us or speak with someone of our church. And now, I want to pray for every Christian who wants to know more of the Holy Spirit in your life and in your ministry, for those who want more and more. Maybe you can stand and raise your hands and raise your hands out as a sign that you want to receive the Holy Spirit, that you want more. Holy Spirit, we thank you that you want to help us. And please give us more from you. Give us more from your power. We need your power every day. Today we say that we really need you in our life and in our world. We ask to be forgiven for our sins. Maybe because sometimes we ignore you, Lord. Many times, Lord, or maybe many days, we don't ask for your presence, or maybe we can grieve you. We ask for your power. We ask special today for your anointing, Holy Spirit. Please, we ask for your gift and talents, for your fruit of love, of peace, of joy, for more of you, Holy Spirit. We recognize how much we need of you, Holy Spirit. Please, please, Lord, fill us with the presence of your Holy Spirit, that let us to feel your glory, to receive every blessing, Lord, we are asking for. Help, Lord, everybody in need, every person in the church, Lord, to have a new hunger for you and a new partnership with you. We come to you now, Lord. Ask for more, more, Lord, more of you. Thank you, Lord, for your Holy Spirit, for your presence today, for your word, Lord. We will guard your word in our hearts, Lord. We will remind your word and declare your word and ask for more from today. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen. Now, if you are sick, I also want to pray for you. Maybe put your hand over the part of your body that needs healing, and I want to pray for healing. And you need to believe and ask for more, the Lord. More. More health. By the blood of Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus, I pray now for all who need your healing today. I thank you that your power and the power of your blood, Jesus, is still the same as it has always been. Please, right now, send your healing anointing to each person who is reaching out to you in faith. Touch them, Lord. Deliver them. Give them healing in their bodies, Lord. Healing in their hearts. Healing in their emotions, Lord. From today, they receive the healing of God in the name of Jesus Christ and in the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen.